Well, this is a good start. I have a feeling this isn't gonna end well.
looks like it didn't work after all, sort of. yeah. I did really like the zebras overall, but especially the two on the top rightish part. So I transfer those two onto another piece of paper of a smaller dimension because I was being a little bit too ambitious about the original piece, and I doubt I had enough time to finish it. I do wish I made the zebra at the back higher so the face isn't obscured by the one in front, or drew the pair interacting with each other a bit more. It didn't actually click in my head at the time because I used to do the style a few years ago where I painted a lineless way. So these animals were usually completely different to each other in terms of pose and style, and they weren't really intended to be cohesive. But after I painted the animals, I would bring it together with plants that are more of the same style to fill in the spaces, and that brought the image together into one instead of separate pieces. And I remember the plants took forever to do. So I had an inkling it would take a couple of days if I stuck to the original dimension of the painting that I did at the start, which I don't have. Yeah. Unfortunately, time is now my biggest issue. I never have enough of it now. But I wanted to use this painting style despite having not done it for such a long time because it's quite soft and dreamy and sort of suits the cutesy way that I want to draw the zebras, especially with the long eyelashes, which are a homage to Christopher, who creates pieces with amazing, beautiful eyes with matching eyelashes that are equally fabulous. And instead of my usual plants that I like to paint, you know, the ones that look sort of like hay or wheat but colored in green, I wanted to have more of a African savanna feel. So that's what I googled. Unfortunately, the savanna doesn't have many interesting plants, apart from some very resilient trees. So I picked a kind of an interesting grass called the elephant plant, elephant grass, and a red flowering succulent thing that I can't find the name to. I thought the red of that flowering succulent really brought the piece together, especially since I used such a warm pinkish color for the blush in the ears, and the rest of the picture was so neutral that it needed that extra pop of red. So on top of that, I really wanted to utilize the characteristic of watercolors by using the wet on wet technique. I always find that Western, or I guess European, okay, I know Russia isn't either, I think. They're a tad difficult to classify which continent they are on, but you know what I mean. They do have a lot of European art style and artwork, so I'm just gonna count them as European in this video. But yeah, European or Western watercolors tend to be a lot more granular and flows a lot better in water than Asian watercolors, at least in my opinion. I mean, just looking at the painting in this video, you can see the texture of the brown in the background. It definitely adds some earthy, naturally feel, and kind of like the texture of when land is really dry and it hasn't been touched by moisture for many years. I wonder that dryness, because that's what is usually associated with the savanna in Africa. So I knew this piece would have to be done with White Nights watercolor paints. I haven't used them since early last year, but opening them bought that familiar, sickening sweet scent that I talk about every single time I use White Nights. Kind of funny how I instantly know and associate a smell with an art supply, and honestly, it's kind of quite comforting because it's so familiar. I actually don't have much more to say. My mind is kind of completely blank, and talking is kind of hard right now. But I urge you all to watch the entire A to Z animal by Google prompt that Christopher had worked so hard on these last few months, as well as the pieces that the other artists had created in collaboration with him. Especially the letter Z, which everyone is joining to celebrate with Christopher. And yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. Happy painting. Until next time, and bye!